Come on. Chirp, 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 chirp. Come on, come on, come on. Big boy.
Bandy the Partridge was a very unusual bird. He limps when he walks and he chirps when he talks, but you can understand every word. Folks from miles around come to see this feathered friend, but the Lord on high keeps this bird in the sky and will protect him to the end. There's a lesson here for all of us as we travel down life's highway. If we hold his hand and by faith we stand, we can face each brand new day. Partridge, you're a blessing to behold, and may we like you be faithful and true, even when we become old. And may we like you be faithful and true, even when we become old. His eyes on a sparrow, and I know he watches me.
So what did you think? You know, you heard about this bird. When was the first time you saw Banny? Roughly.
When was the first time?
This year, right?
Yeah, this year. I think probably in the spring of the year, wasn't it, that we came out here?
And you and Dwayne?
And Dwayne, yeah. And
what was it this area? Or?
In this area, okay. Yeah. And Dwayne called him for, I'm going to say, probably half an hour, whistling for him, and normally he would come in that time, but it didn't show up. And I thought, well, don't look like I'm going to see the little boy anyway. Just as we was walking, to the car, I believe, to go away. Then we looked back, and here was that bandy coming down here. And oh, man, I can't believe this. This is a wild bird, but yet this thing is acting like a tame chicken. And I said to Dwayne, I said, does this thing ever fly? Because I know how a partridge flies. They fly like a bull, you know, going through the woods.
Yeah.
And he says, yeah, he says, they've seen it fly. I said, oh, this is unbelievable. So then when we got down here, this thing jumped up on us and got on our hands and talking to us, and we just couldn't believe what was happening. And I couldn't get it out of my mind. You know, I thought about it all night long, and then Dwayne showed me pictures of you, Norm, and Bandy on your belly, laying
that's
down.
That's what frustrated bow hunters do when they don't see deer.
about like,
God feels sorry for them and sends them wild partridges to have fun with.
No, it's an amazing story about this little thing, and just to think it lives out here alone, and that somehow I believe the Lord's watching over this little bird.
I was asking Dwayne if he'd be willing to share about the episode where Bandy got his leg hurt, and so he said he'd be willing. So anyway, go back and tell, you know, what happened.
Okay, in this area, one day I pulled right up here, and it was getting a little close to winter, just before the winter there, and it was already cold and everything. I stopped down here with the four-wheeler, the quad, and there come little Bandy. I called for him. He came up and jumped up on my hand. And I just shut the quad off, and he'd jump over on this arm, jump over on that arm. Then I was just holding the handlebars, and he'd go around the handlebar like this and up this arm, then back around and up this arm, back down around and back up this arm. Then he says, I just sat there for a while, and then he kept playing. I says, you're going to get hurt. And he jumped over on the handlebars, and then there's a little brake reservoir to hold the brake fluid for the front brakes, and his foot slipped down there between there. And he got caught and he started flying like this, but he couldn't go nowhere because his foot was hooked. And I couldn't do nothing for him because he's flapping so hard, those wings hurt if they hit you. Anyhow, when he dropped and let go, then I seen he was hooked by his leg in that place. Then I picked him up real gently and I slid his leg out real gently. And then he didn't peck at all, and I pulled his leg out and looked to see if there's something I could do. And I noticed that, you know, he was injured. So he stayed with me a little bit, but he got down. He'd kind of make some noises and stuff. He started walking into the woods, and I seen him just limping, almost hopping on the good leg. And so I called my daughter, and she called the DNR. DNR says, well, if he just hung by his leg, he probably just sprained it. He didn't break it. He's probably okay. And so I stayed with him the rest of the day, and he'd hide under some of the bushes and stuff. And I didn't want to leave him at night on the ground. I wanted to make sure he was up in a tree. So I took him and put him up by the tree, and he'd jump up. And then I seen him get up on a top branch. DNR said that they'd come out and put him down if he wasn't okay, but I didn't want that, so I says I'll keep an eye on him now. Made it all the way through the winter. I'd find him up front where he's eating off the garbage pit and stuff, and through the winter I prayed for him, and I'll tell you, I prayed for him that night before I left that the Lord would keep the little bird, and he did, and he made it all the way through the winter. He's getting kind of weak now, but we've had a lot of fun with that little guy.
Okay.
Partridge is a very unusual bird. He limps when he walks, and he chirps when he talks, but you can understand every word. People from miles around come to see this feathered friend, but the Lord on high keeps this bird in the sky. He'll protect him till the end. There's a lesson here for all of us as we travel down life's highway. If we hold his hand and by faith we stand, we can face each brand new day. So Banty, the partridge, you're a blessing to behold, and may we like you be faithful and true, even when we become old. And may we like you be faithful and true, even when we become old. His eye is on the sparrow.